Welcome to bmmlife.com. Today we are going to finally begin with QuarkXPress. Let's open up QuarkXPress. I'm using version 10.2.1 and I'm using a Mac OS system. But most of the functions carry forward to lower versions of QuarkXPress and also over to Windows system. So once you have opened up QuarkXPress, you get this panel. In this panel, you have the option to open a recent project. Since we don't have any recent projects, it is blank. We have an option to create a new project or a library, and we have resources. For all practical purposes, we only need to use this portion of the panel. To create a new project, click on Project. This new dialog box pops up. It is a very good idea to always give your layout a name. The first text box is your layout name. So today we are going to start planning out our magazine. So we'll write magazine design. We have to choose our layout type, which is print. We also have the option to publish for EPUB or for Kindle devices. But for now, we need to use print. The size options, you have to choose from a variety of sizes. We are going to start with A4 size. We are most familiar with A4 size. Then these are the margin guides, how much margin from all the sides of the page, how much space has to be left. The columns, the number of columns and the width of each column. It is a good idea to have many columns, and it is always a good idea to have the number of columns in multiples of 2. So 2, 4, 8. So we are going to choose 16 columns. Rest everything has to be left as it is. And then click on OK. As soon as we click OK, we are presented with this interface. Press Command or Control on your PC and 0 to scale everything to fit in your view. This entire page that you see is page 1 of your magazine. QuarkXPress and many desktop publishing tools have something called a master page. To view your master page, you have to click on Windows, go to page layout, and then you have this option of seeing your master page. Now notice what happens when I double click on it. You get to the master page. To get back to your main page, page number 1, you have to click on this tab here, and you are directed to your first page of the magazine. Now what is a master page? Think of it as a template for your entire magazine. So whatever you put on the master page is going to apply to all the pages that fall under this master page. You can create a new master page by right clicking, selecting new single page master, and you get a new single page master. Now you can, if you double click on this new master, you will be directed to the new master page, the old master page, and you can add pages by going to your A master page, going to your page number 1 in A master page, right clicking here and clicking insert pages. So you have the option to insert one. You can type in 2, 20, 200, whatever. You can choose before page number 1 or after page number 1 or at the very end of the layout if you want to select which master page you want it to refer from. So right now we are going to select master page A and click OK. So we get this second page, new page, page number 2, which is linked to our main template page, which is master A. We can go ahead, click on this insert page, and let's see what happens if we choose master page B and click OK. Now we get us another master page which falls in the same line. When you print this, they are going to be of the same template, of the same magazine. When you print this, they are going to be pages of the same magazine in this very order, but the template page for page number 1 and 2 is going to be different from the template page of page number 3. So let me explain what I mean by that. Let's just delete this page for now. Delete this page for now. And now we are going to go back to our page number 1. Now, most pages in your magazine are going to carry certain basic things like page number on the footer. So you're going to carry page number, you're going to carry, if there is a website, the website name, you're going to carry the name of the publication on every single page. So you can set that up without having to worry about publishing each individual page separately, typing it out on each individual page separately. You can set that up on your master page. Now, how do you do that? You can go to, all you have to do is select your master page, create text box. I'm just creating a text box of any size for reference purpose, and you have to type in whatever you want to that you want to appear on every page. So let's type www.tmmlife.com. Select it all and let me just resize it so that you can view it better. So resize it to 36 points, maybe 72 points. Resize it to 36 points. Now you have typed in this, and now when you go to your page 1, nothing seems to change. But when you add a new page and you refer it from page master page A, the new page, when you double click on it, will by default have this text box in it. You can move it around, you can even delete it from this page. Page 1 will still have it. You have deleted it from page number 2, and when you add it to page number 3, it will still have it. So this text box comes from master page A. That's it for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we are going to discuss what all these tools here are used for individually, and we are also going to discuss how to design the cover page for your magazine. Thank you.